open with this documentary with a contribution, Mkokoko, Future Afloat, directed by our winning filmmaker Femi Odugmbemi. So let's see this part.
When in school, we want the next generation and our children to be able to go to school. If our forefathers were able to go to school, this place would have been developed more than this. I found that education is very important. I know how hard it is for me to be educated. As I got to primary six, going to JS1, I now started realizing some things that I'm making new friends, going to speaking some language that people don't understand in our community. From there, I now focus on education. And I look at the next generation. What's gonna happen?
In the year 2008, the philanthropist from our side decided to come into our community to know what we are lacking of. They started constructing Wainan School.
Wainan means love. That means if these people didn't love us, they can't come and build this school for us. That was the first school we have in the community. I'm just graduating from secondary school in the year 2007. My brother called me that it's my turn, that I need to come and party, I need to come and help. I was looking at myself that probably, for me, I have to further my education. How can I stop my education, come and be teaching, doing all these things? My mom now told me that I should do it compulsory. For the first day, we have 68 students that is with us. In the year 2008, I myself were the only one that are taking them, and I tried to talk to some of my friends within the community. Please, let's do this. This is our community. If we don't do it, nobody will come and do it for us. We can't wait for government. The government is coming tomorrow, it's coming next tomorrow. We come and build schools, come and educate children. Let's start something. From there, we begin to teach the children. First class, we start teaching the students in the year 2008. We don't have any syllabus. We start with our empty brain, and the textbook. In the year 2009, I have to go to the market to go and look for a good curriculum. Encourage the parent that if you send your child to school, your child might become a doctor, an engineer, a president, and that. From there, they now focus on education that, no, my child has to go to school. My child has to go to school.
We don't pay because they don't collect money. When you say 30 naira, it's just to make surroundings clean. And the balance, the community, if they are resenting for renovation, they contribute.
In the school, we have 218 students, and we also have more than 200 kids that have registered, which we cannot accommodate. I met a friend, he's an architect. I explained our condition to him that we need more school, we need a place to accommodate these children. From there, we finally have the 14th school, and the 14th school is an extension of the existing school to accommodate more children. What inspired me most is that after we teach the children finish, they'll come back to us and say, thank you, uncle. That thank you means a lot to me, that the children really know what we are doing to them.
That is why I take this as a challenge, that no matter anything, if the little that I was given, I will accept it like that and contribute the little that I can to the development of these children.
I want to change their life, and I want people to come here, to come and help them, so that they can be great in the future.
We really need expansion, either floating or expand the existing structure. We need anybody that can assist to pay some of the staff salary, either by giving them cash or in any means. We need support for the teachers, and we need support of stationaries, we need support of furniture, and we need support of power boats.
banje yire nu banu mi e mo le jije ru ni na ya bi o le yire ye ma ya wo e bo ya kan ro we wu yo me de ga mi ya ro mi do gbe ni na toria ke ma do ni e wa mo kun nu mi le kun mi gaji ni ya do a bi o le